North Korean leader Kim Jong-un visits industrial or military facilities quite often. There is one thing that South Korean media focuses on when North Korea's Joseon Central TV broadcasts Kim's visit to such places, and that is who the escorts are. Because according to the members of his entourage, the message Kim wants to send and the situation of power dynamics in the North government are shown. So this week, North Korea Now will look into the key entourage of Kim Jong-un these days. There are main three members who always accompany Kim when he visits those facilities. You can also make a guess. First, there is Kim's sister Kim Yo-jung, who is a senior Workers' Party official. In fact, she was one of the busiest in Kim Jong-un's entourage to Hanoi, Vietnam last February. She also came into the spotlight as a footage was released showing her standing next to Kim Jong-un, holding an ashtray at Nanning Station, a stopover in China. The second member is First Vice Department Director Cho Yong-won of the ruling party, who was dubbed Kim's shadow man. He was the person who most frequently accompanied the leader on his public appearances this year, as he was in 2017 and 2018. And Hyun Sung-won, head of the North Samjin Orchestra, appears to have taken over the sister's previous role as a protocol official for the leader. We can say that these three are most certainly part of the inner circle. They are like the shadows of Kim Jong-un. And sometimes Kim's wife Lee Seol-ju, or Choi Ryong-hae, president of the North Presidium of the Supreme People's Assembly, or Choi Seon-hee, first vice foreign minister, and Ma Won-chun, director of a bureau of the State Affairs Commission, joined the North Korean leader. However, there are two other people that Kim brings with him quite often these days wherever he goes. Park Jong-chun, chief of the general staff, and Chang Geum-chul, chief of the North United Front Department, or UFD. Park Jong-chun, the chief of the general staff, is equivalent to South Korea's chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, so he's the second most powerful rank in the military. And Chang replaced Kim Yong-chul, who served as the North's top envoy in nuclear negotiations with the United States. The replacement was seen as a move to hold Kim responsible for February's no-deal summit with the US. Now, let's have a look at Park and Chang's recent escort schedules. Not only at the military event, Park was also accompanying Kim while the leader was going up the Paektu Mountain on a white horse and went to Yangdeok Hot Spring Resort, but also responded to Trump's remarks that there may be use of military force against North Korea should it be necessary by releasing a statement on December 4th, which stated the armed force will be responded with armed forces. The reputation of the military officials has lowered significantly after Kim Jong-un came to power compared to when his father Kim Jong-il was in power. However, some experts suspect that the military official status has risen again, seeing recent movements regarding Park. In fact, as the nuclear negotiations with the US has been at a stalemate, North Korea has threatened to take a new way, hinting that it otherwise will end diplomacy and revert to provocative behavior. On the other hand, as foreign issues such as the US and South Korea become important during this year-end period, Kim may want to be advised on such subjects often from Chang Geum-chul. When Kim just took over the leadership, the late Kim Yang-gun, then chief of UFD, was seen to be advising Kim quite often while he followed Kim around, and there are interpretations that Chang has taken on that role. What are your thoughts on this? Please let me know in the comments below, and thank you for watching North Korea Now!